Good day, YouTube. How's everybody doing out there? I hope I'm finding everybody well during this time of trials and tribulations, pandemic, crisis, boogaloo, shelter in place, stay at home, whatever you want to call it. Found myself with a lot of time on my hands. Usually I work 70 hours a week and I don't have time to do videos. Certain people stalling to me about doing videos, but it's tough. I work all the time. Well, now that I get to sit at home all day and do nothing, absolutely nothing, I'm kind of enjoying it. I got some tasks to do, some stuff to do around the house that I've put off for a week, a month, a year. So we're getting all that done. Just enjoying life. I hope everybody's prepared for it, or as prepared as much as they can be. Try to limit your time going outside into the world. I know it's tough. It's tough for a lot of people. I see people I know, my neighbors doing it. They just can't sit at home. They're like, I gotta go to the store. I need a loaf of bread. I need a bag of potato. I mean, buy as much potato chips as you can. Don't go get one bag. What are you gonna do next week? You're gonna leave again. Eventually, we haven't seen the worst yet. This stuff is gonna ramp up. In 2 to 3 weeks, it's gonna be, I got a feeling we're gonna be pretty bad off. Hopefully the warmer weather, it's 80 some degrees out here today. Hopefully that slows it down. Hopefully this self-distancing slows it down, social distancing, whatever you want to call it. Hopefully that helps us. There's a lot of things we can do to mitigate what's going on and protect ourselves. But the biggest one is just stay at home. Don't go out. Don't take unnecessary risks. Now, you take a risk when you order food and they bring your food. You take a risk when you go to the store. You take a risk when you talk to your neighbors. Keep the 10 feet. I'm not doing 6 feet. I'm doing 10 feet. Stay 10 feet. I can talk to you from 10 feet away perfectly. Keep your distance. And this will blow over. Now, the economic impact, not so sure about. Hopefully it springs back. I mean, I can't go 3-4 months without working. It's going to be tough. But if the world goes 3 to 4 months without working, there's going to be plenty of people really bad off. I hope everybody out there has some level of preparedness that's watching this. We've had years to prepare for this. We didn't know what it was going to be. You never know what it's going to be. You prepare for one thing and another happens. So that's why you have to level out your preparedness. You can't just be, oh, I need guns. I need this. I need that. And not have bandages. You can't have fuel and gasoline and not have canned goods, because you never know what you're preparing for. That's the whole thing about being prepared, preparing for the unexpected. This was totally unexpected. A worldwide pandemic, a virus that's not much deadlier than the flu. It seems to spread faster. It seems to affect certain people in our population differently. And with social media now and on-demand media and all that, people are just taking it to a whole new level. Do I think it's any worse than the swine flu or any of those other epidemics we've had happen? No. This has spread super fast, though. Super rapid. And you're getting real-time news. You're not hearing about people that were infected yesterday. You're hearing about people that tested positive 20 minutes ago now. So you're getting more real-time information. And with social media and Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, whatever it is you follow or listen to, it's all over that. It's all over everything. So it's drove a higher sense of awareness and a higher sense of concern. But I believe that'll pass. What we're going to have to recover from is the economic scars it's going to leave. People out of work for months. The stores, from what I understand, like masks and stuff, toilet paper, we went through 7 months supply in a week. They had enough stored up for the next 7 months and it's gone. That's a lot of product. That's a lot of manufacturing that has to be done. A lot of manufacturing that doesn't take place in the United States anymore. So, hopefully that will increase our manufacturing prowess and we'll start producing stuff made in the USA again. We'll get back to making stuff here. So we're more prepared next time. You should be more prepared next time. You've seen your weaknesses. My weakness, water. I have water stored up. I have a well. We have power right now, so everybody's being civil. What if we didn't have power? What if I'd have to run a generator just to get water out of the ground? I have minimal water stopped, enough for a couple of days, basically. But I don't have the level of water or the water procurement to be able to maintain my household. I rely on my well, and my well relies on power. I was just back here looking. I do live in the city of Charlotte. When I moved here, I didn't live in the city. I lived with a bunch of woods around me. Now my house is back up the hill over there now. And I do have a couple acres. I have woods. I have squirrels. I have deer. But I do have neighbors now. You'll probably hear chainsaws. I heard a wood chipper going earlier. Now I can't just go walk. I can see houses through the woods now, whereas before I couldn't. It was nothing but wilderness. They drained. There was a pond down here. They've drained it and put in a subdivision. So I can't go in my backyard and shoot. Not everybody has a homestead. You know, I feel like I'm probably slightly above the average. Most people have an acre, 2 acre. I have a couple acres. Plus I have, like, I guess they're communal woods. I don't know. Somebody owns them, who knows. But nothing's done on them. Nothing's kept up on them. Nobody comes back here, so I do have that. I just wanted to put some content out there. I may make some more videos. I got a bunch of ideas for some videos I can do, because I feel like we're going to be on stay at home for the next 3 weeks at least. I think we're 2 to 3 weeks before this thing peaks and plateaus and enough people get sick that people start taking it seriously. A lot of people aren't taking it seriously right now. Stay at home. Quit going to the stores just because you need a gallon of milk. Plan your trips. Buy a couple of weeks of supplies if you can. If you don't have the money, what are you going to do? Are you working? Are you going to have the money in a week? I got a friend like that. He won't go buy a lot because he's like, well, I'm not working. What am I going to do if I do, you know, if this and that? What are you going to do? Yeah, what are you going to do? You might as well. You've got the money. You don't want to spend it. It's not going away in 7 days. It's not going away in 14 days. It's here for months. I want to thank all the content providers out there putting out videos for us during this time. I'm enjoying them immensely. I know it's tough. You got things going on at your home, but you still have time to put out a video or 10 or do a live stream every day or just keep us updated on your life. So big shout out to that. You know who you are. Scooch, Shitty Medic. Jim Yeager. I think we're going to do some MRE eating videos. I enjoy watching those, and I think that'd be fun. From my perspective, it'd be different. And I'm not going to lay it out on a tray. I'm just going to eat it. I'm going to eat it like you really would in the field, out of the bag. May not even heat it up. I don't know. You guys will let me know. I'm not saying the C word because I don't want to put that stupid little banner below this video. I think we should call this Real Talk with Rodney.